Alright guys, so now I want to dive a little deeper into the reagents of oxidation. So, just so you guys know, all of these reagents that we're going to talk about in this topic can be generalized as oxidizing agents, okay? Now I remember when I was in Gen Chem, and you had like oxidizing agents, reducing agents, oxidation. It was kind of confusing sometimes, like the oxidizing agent gets reduced. There's a lot of different stuff you have to memorize. Or maybe I was just stupid, I don't know. But all I know is that in Orgo, it's really not complicated at all. All you have to think about is that the oxidizing agent is the thing that oxidizes your molecule, okay? So if you're trying to oxidize a molecule, make more bonds to oxygen, you're going to use an oxidizing agent. It's that easy, okay? So there's a general rule that you really need to follow with all these reactions, even if you don't know the mechanism. There's just a rule that you can use, and that's that oxidizing agents are going to add as much oxygen as possible while not breaking any carbon-carbon bonds, okay? Now, this is a little bit of a lie. There are some oxidizing reagents that can break carbon-carbon bonds, okay? Some examples that you might already know would be, for example, ozonolysis, okay? That would be an example of an oxidation that can. But that's not what we're going to talk about in this topic. That's its own separate topic. For right now, I'm trying to deal with these oxidizing agents that don't break carbon-carbon bonds, okay? So I'll get to what they are in a second, but even before we know what the reagents are, we could already jump into a practice problem. What I'm wondering is, out of these four molecules here, which of them actually could be oxidized? What I'm basically saying is, how many of them could you add bonds to oxygen without breaking a carbon-carbon bond? All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and let you guys figure that out. Get back to me, which of these could be oxidized?